We've all heard the stories about people like Michael Burry making millions off the stock market during a crash. This incident was so famous that a movie was made about it called The Big Short. Not only Michael Burry, but you can make money, even $1 million or more, if you know the strategies guarded by the most successful traders. How much you make is all based upon the amount you have to invest up front and your patience in learning these skills. I'm Lynn with 60 Perfect Ways to Wealth. In this series, I'm going to share 3 different strategies clearly explaining how successful stock traders profit from stock market crashes. None of these strategies include short selling, as I avoid the potential huge losses that occur from shorting. If you aren't an expert in the strategy, I've watched traders take hundreds of thousands of dollars of losses from short selling, so I just don't. I've invested and traded through the longer stock market crashes of 2000 and 2009 and the shorter steep pullback of 2020. Today, I'll share what I've learned from these experiences and from my 2.5 decades of studying the stock market. First, I'm going to show you how to spot a stock market crash plus good entry and exit points, then explain the trading method in detail. This first method enables the largest upside profits, but to master it, you will need to first practice and then second, learn to watch and track the market while controlling your emotions. Your success depends upon you mastering these 2 factors. But first, if you find value in this video, this is a friendly reminder to hit the thumbs up button and leave a comment below. There is no guarantee that you will make money, and this video is for your information and entertainment only. I have included a clickable index below this video in case you want to rewatch specific parts of this video or jump around. First, let's talk about how to spot a stock market crash. Step 1, a downturn hasn't even started unless there are at least 2 consecutive daily charting candles with lower lows and lower highs. This is a very important signal for short-term traders, but doesn't yet signal an actual market crash. A market crash can be first led by a downturn in the S&P 500 index or the Nasdaq's faster-moving growth stock. To clarify the term growth, it means that the company has substantial room for capital appreciation. Growth stock companies are often from sectors like technology or biotech. I tend to watch both the S&P 500 index by following the related ETF SPY and the NASDAQ through its related ETF QQQ. How do you spot this market crash? You need to learn patience to wait for the actual signal to enter into a longer-term market crash trade. A market crash is actually easy to spot if you have your broker's charting program set up with the following exponential moving averages: a 25-day, a 50-day, and a 100-day. Plus, your chart needs to be displaying weekly candlesticks. This means that each candlestick is reflecting 1 week's price movement for either the SPY or QQQ ETFs. A longer-term market crash confirmation occurs when the 25-day moving average crosses over the 50 and 100-day moving averages. A movement like this of a 1-day or smaller time frame candle does not indicate a market crash. Weekly candlesticks reflect strong market sentiment, so are the candlestick timelines to follow. Let's quickly take a look at the exponential moving average crossovers for 2000, 2008, and 2020 and compare them. You can see these crossovers occurred during 2001 and 2008, but not in 2020, which signified that this 2020 pullback was a shorter term market correction. Now that you know how to spot a deeper and longer term stock market crash, exactly how do you profit from this crash? One of the easiest ways to profit from a crash is by trading an inverse ETF such as the SDS, which is the ultra inverse bear or 2x of the SPY, or the QID, which is the 2x inverse bear of the QQQ. Or for lower risk and lower upside potential, you can use the 1x S&P 500 ETF SH or the 1x NASDAQ ETF PSQ. It's of key importance when picking an inverse ETF that it has a large average trading volume for daily trades so that you can quickly trade in and out of a fund when needed. You can check the average volume for a stock or an ETF through its Yahoo Finance profile or through FinViz. See the link in my description below. Currently, we have a significant opportunity to profit from an inverse ETF trade. In 2008, at the start of this major stock market crash, SES was at $1,048 per share and improved to $1,517 per share in 1 month. Obviously, the initial cost of $1,048 would limit the number of shares the average retail investor could afford to buy. Currently, SES is $9.50 per share. So even if it increased to 3 or even 5 times its current value by the time a crash occurs, there is an opportunity to buy many more shares. Note that QID was over $13,000 per share when the crash started and is currently $23.46 per share. If you'd like confirmation of a large amount of movement in the stock market during a correction, during the largest initial downturn market movements, the VIX, V-I-X, which tracks the market's volatility, will be quite elevated. This signifies a stock market being traded, whether being sold, shorted, or buying of inverse ETFs at a larger volume. But it will start dropping consistently during a longer-term stock market crash once the correction begins. If you'd like me to make a more detailed video explaining exactly how to use the VIX and its key levels, let me know in the comments below. When watching an ETF for a longer-term investment or for market crash, I always set up my chart with Heikinashi candlesticks. This type of charting candlestick will make it much easier for you to spot market trends. I made an entire video on Heikinashi candlesticks that I will link at the end of this video and in the description below. So when do you get out of a stock market crash inverse ETF? Before we continue, if you haven't yet, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for the rest of the Make Millions from a Stock Market Crash series. The timing of exactly when you jump out of an inverse trade is a personal decision regarding how long you want to hang on for more profit but risk a potential market reversal. Once you've entered an inverse ETF trade, it's best to switch to using its chart as a daily candlestick view or even a 4-hour candlestick view, as the major uptrends can occur in shorter spurts of 8 to 12 days. This means you'll want to make a decision at the time of entering a trade at what price or type of price movement you plan to exit the trade, both on the upside or downside. As the stock market has historically over its entire history increased in value over time, I do like to get back into my wide market ETFs such as SPY, VOO, QQQ, or XLK once the market corrects. I've made videos covering in detail how to spot a crash for each of these ETFs and how to determine a safe re-entry point. You can access these videos at the end card here in the How to Make Millions from a Stock Market Crash playlist, as well as a video on using the Heikinashi candlesticks.